Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts.
Yay!
Well, that's all you have to say, Chorps, after the month we've been gone.
It's been so long, I forgot what to say.
After that crazy fucking king kidnapped us.
Sorry, I forgot to read the script.
Where we left off, every month was October, though, so we've lost no time.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's December now, you know what that means. It's time to go to Peter Pan.
Right. My favorite Christmas movie.
Okay.
You know what? You know, let's talk about some favorite Christmas traditions, though.
Flying around in a toilet.
Yeah, my favorite is the one in which I sit on a toilet.
And fly around space.
Yeah, I sit in a toilet and I eat an entire turkey. That's my Christmas.
Are any of those a present, or is that just something you do besides the presents?
Wait, presents?
Yes, I see you are partaking in the old holiday tradition of building low-poly models of your red-headed cousins and pointing violence
upon
them.
You know, I hate those guys. They never give me my Christmas turkey.
You just assemble pieces of turkey, so they give you some drumsticks, so one guy gives you the wishbone.
Yes, the ceremonial bird exchange has occurred in the old country.
Yeah.
It's really fucked up, because it's still a living turkey, which, you know, it's tradition.
It takes a little bit of getting used to working on the boneless farms.
Yeah,
your turkey
true.
Is just a weird jelly pile of scales and feathers.
Are you sure you know what a turkey is? Are you actually just eating like a live raw fish?
Oh my god.
What are you talking about? Birds or dinosaurs?
Yeah.
That's science.
I mean, what are your guests gonna tell me next? That the Earth is round?
Are you B.O.B.? Did you just dox yourself?
Oh no. I knew LP was a bad idea.
Whoa, wait, what? This is the first time anything like this is- what? Is it gonna eat us like that whale? This is just like that whale sequence.
That's a poor-ass ram. It didn't even touch your ship at all.
I think that's probably
that
for
is not
best.
A ram, that is parking. The fuck did this ocean come from? There was no ocean here. This boat was in space.
If you think about it, space is just a really big ocean.
I didn't think you'd come, Sora. Good to see you again.
Oh, hey. Is this guy again?
That's pretty cool.
Hate him.
Are they that important to you? More important than our friends? Instead of worrying about
we docked.
Them, you should be asking.
No, we docked. Wait, her. What?
Did Riku join the Navy, by the way?
You were off goofing around.
Well, no, they're our friends.
Good job, bro. Mission accomplished.
Not so fast. No shenanigans aboard my vessel, boy.
Riku, why are you siding with the Heartless?
The Heartless obey me now, Sora. Now I have nothing to fear.
You're stupid.
Nothing to fear so but a good old pirate mutiny.
He was doing something.
My heart's too strong.
Riku!
I've picked up a few other tricks as well. Like
pulls out two juggle balls and just starts going hog wild.
You can go see your friends now.
Yeah, see, he made a Sora that won't betray him.
Let's get underway already.
I suppose so.
And keep Sora away from Kairi until we're ready to land.
He can skateboard.
That scurvy brat thinks he can order me around.
What shall we do, Captain Hook?
Nothing! The hold is crawling with Heartless. Let them keep an eye on the brats.
But, Captain, you know who is also down...
Shh! Did you hear that, Smee? Oh, that dreadful sound.
No, Captain.
Are you quite sure? Did I imagine it?
You're going fucking crazy, Captain.
Gotta look good when you're out on the high seas.
Yeah, it was definitely Kairi. I finally found her.
All right.
This is a very bizarre
cameraman,
positioning.
Please.
What is exactly happening in this scene? Okay.
Well, they're just having a nice dog pile.
Why did Sora just hang around like that for minutes?
Oh, no. Maybe this is the true bond of friendship where you just lie on top of each other and not give a shit.
Looking for a way out?
You know, at first, the weird camera work kind of gave the impression they were in a much smaller space, but I guess not.
Okay then, fine.
This is a pretty luxurious prison. Hook's got a whole European system going on.
Nope, I'm just waiting for someone.
I think we were caught by Scandinavian pirates.
Tinkerbell, what took you so long?
So how long were you hiding behind those barrels, Peter Pan?
He was just waiting for the right time to give him a real scare.
There was another girl there, too? Are you crazy? There's no way I'm gonna leave Wendy there.
She must be pretty jealous.
Come on, Tink. Open up the door.
That's why we always switch them out.
I'm Peter Pan.
I'm sorry.
Wow.
Okay. We're in this together, but only
Peter Pan is a huge dick.
Canonically,
he is the worst. But we're still gonna have him at our party, though.
Well, right.
Like, he is a huge dick, and he will probably call us a homo, like, every combat turn, but, like, at least he's better than Donald.
He is still better than Donald.
Oh no, it's our doppelganger!
So yeah, you got two new enemies in this. The pirates, which are basically the next evolution in the melee guys. Pirates can either throw their swords around or just jump up behind you.
Oh, like the sword guys from Arabia. Agrabah.
Yeah. Yeah. There were a mix of the sword guys of Arabia and like the mummies from Halloween Town.
From The Mummy, the popular series.
Disney's The Mummy.
It's the return of the mummy, basically.
Oh, okay.
Slightly. He goes fucking nuts every time. So yeah. Another Heartless is also your doppelganger. Your doppelganger just fucking floats around and dances like an asshole. That's all he does.
Does he even attack?
No. Yeah, he just taunts you.
Yeah, I've learned a new trick, handing out free experience. Easy money.
Look at this thing I built, Sora. It's just like you, except can't attack. So it's worthless.
It's just
to
like
me.
You, completely useless.
Whoa!
Oh, damn. Looks like Sora's gotta take place in the own zone.
That's
messed
up.
I don't even know what sentence that meant.
Depends where it's just happened. Let it go.
Everyone's frozen in time, and yet we can still move to the beat of the ocean.
It's like art.
We're basically all beat poets here.
Isn't LP just impressionist art, really?
Yeah. Okay, buddy, I forgot my drums. I'm real sorry.
Just think about it for a moment, viewer. You are the audience of an audience to the audience of the product. That is how many layers removed you are from this piece of media.
That's messed up.
Pirates are real dangerous. That's my beat, poets.
Yar.
So, how come you can fly?
Anyone can fly.
Aw, man. Are we gonna learn how to fly?
Alright, first of all, you need $2,000 and 12 months of lessons.
Haven't you came
Just a little bit of pixie dust. There. Now you can fly.
You'd think of all of them, Donald would already know.
Well, first off, you have to send in $5,000 to the official address so you can get the official flying ropes.
What? So Wendy's not one of the chosen
ones? There are seven, supposedly. The Maleficent says...
I guess you wasted your time, Huck.
Hoist anchor as soon as possible. Leave all the dead weight behind, including her.
After the trouble of capturing her? And why those seven? What is Maleficent planning anyway?
Who knows? As long as it means getting Kyrie's heart back, I couldn't care less.
You're wasting your time.
The Heartless have devoured that girl's heart. I'll stake me other hand, it's lost forever.
I will find it, no matter what.
Captain?
What?
The prisoners have escaped.
God, Smee's voice is like the least dramatic thing to ruin any scene.
Was there even a lock on that prison?
I feel like you just walked out. We may have had to kill a doppelganger, but like...
What is it, Tink? Peter? Peter Pan?
Man, those hammocks look fucking luxurious. What the fuck is up with Hook's prison system?
Why do you want to leave?
This pirate cruise ship we stumbled into.
Wendy? Yes?
Is there another girl in there with you?
Oh, why, yes. But she seems to be asleep. She hasn't budged an inch.
What?
You look at someone glass-eyed and hasn't moved in hours, so you're like, yeah, she's asleep. You never know what danger lurks around the corner, right, Peter Pan?
I'm pretty sure she used a vegetable Sora. She's...
Oh, no!
That wasn't actual movement, she just kind of twitched a little.
It's so fucked up that our anime friend is in a coma, and Sora is still holding up hope. How do we break this news to him? We're gonna have to pull the plug on her.
What if that was just a doppelganger, though? Wait, what?
So, yeah, we need to do some Trinity shit, so we need Donald and Goofy back in form.
Alright, this LP's bad.
Can't believe you ruined the LP, future friend.
You could have just used Peter Pan for that. He can fly.
No, he can't. He can't use Trinity marks at all.
Peter Pan can't fly.
We should be able to use the duck for that. He's a bird. We got a worthless bird on you.
Peter Pan sees that mark on the ground. Is like, I don't know what the fuck that is. What an idiot.
He's
an
a bird
asshole.
And a wizard.
Riku, wait.
Oh no, that one actually has a weapon!
So yeah, hey, welcome to the doppelganger,
The real doppelganger fight.
Yeah, the actual doppelganger fight. He doesn't just do a dance routine and you gotta beat him at that.
I mean, that's nice.
I don't know, I would've preferred a step-up set situation going on in this game. You know, anything to switch it up.
Oh, okay. Like an actual dance-off, like a rhythm game. That could be kind of cool. You have to plug in your DDR dance pad.
Yeah, and you have to dance to the Traverse Town team, the great Traverse Town team.
Right.
What I'm seeing here so far is kind of indistinguishable from a regular Melee Heartless.
Yeah, this guy just kind of fights like a lame you that walks around and is big.
Doesn't have magic?
No, he doesn't have magic. Whenever someone is inside, he does some damage, but otherwise, he doesn't do much else besides that and his doppelganger thing.
I mean, apparently he killed Peter Pan, so...
Yeah, Peter Pan's fucking dead.
Where's your happy thoughts now?
And Peter Pan has the most HP out of everyone, so I feel like maybe you're just lying.
I'm on proud mode, so this guy can kill anyone in like two hits.
Oh, yeah, sure, future friend. I'll believe it when I see it. Oh, Goofy's dead. I guess it's true.
Dang. I can't believe it. This guy's unstoppable. Oh, there we go.
Oh, my God.
Ugh, we get this Jesus symbology, okay?
This is where we unlock our persona.
What would Sora's persona be, you think?
The dick chariot.
Yeah.
That guy on the toilet.
No, that's my persona.
Oh, okay.
Wow, what a dick move, Sora. Hey, this is gonna be so funny. You're just gonna drop Goofy down this trapdoor.
And then we leave.
I'm gonna break his legs. It's gonna be great. And then when Goofy is crying out in pain, chill, bro, it's just a prank. It's just a prank, bro.
It's just a prank.
So we're just trying to find our way out of this, because this seems like a horrible maze of a place.
It is kind of a horrible maze of a place, like most wilderness game.
Right.
But don't worry, we are nearly on deck. We can nearly get the fuck out of here.
At least it's more detailed than Wonderland.
It's, then again, it's also easier to officially design, because, you know, it's a ship.
I guess you're right.
Also, we just needed to walk back here. Like, we only needed to trigger that offense and then walk back here.
Well, thank goodness.
Okay.
So yeah, honestly, at this point in the game, like, on proud mode, like, enemies shouldn't be a big enough of a deal anyway. Like, at this point, you're mostly gonna get your ass kicked by bosses and not by the multitude of enemies because you have so much HP and the enemies kinda don't skill with you that way.
Mm-hmm.
Quite a codfish, that Riku. Running off with
Riku. Without even saying goodbye.
Run off where? Tell me, where did he go?
To the ruins of Hollow Bastion.
Sora just sounds like such a big baby. Where did he go? I want on all.
You won't be going there.
Oh no.
Oh no, that thing that happens like every 5 minutes in this world.
Agreed. Fair trade.
Things have taken a turn for the worse.
You take the small elf and we will be on our way. Good day, sir.
You know, he just handed over and then it would teleport back to him. There's not, like, an issue here.
It's not really a physical object. It's a projection.
Also, it's like four heartless.
No, it's hopeless.
The crocodile that took me hand. Oh, Smee. He's after me other hand.
They really like just kind of throwing stuff from Peter Pan in here.
I like that Smee doesn't give a shit, just standing here.
The other worlds seem to have sort of a plot, sort of based around it. This just seems to be like a hodgepodge of things from Peter Pan.
And then just a raft full of racist stereotypes floats around to save Sora.
Just believe, and you can do it.
Aren't we missing a crucial ingredient here, the fairy dust? Didn't we miss the fairy dust? The fairy dust! The fairy dust! The fairy dust!
Rest in peace, Sora!
He stole some.
Thanks, Peter.
Hey, don't mention.
Hey, it's Peter Pan, you shit.
Use my full name.
We're not cool like that yet.
Just call me Pete's Pete Pan.
Just call him a Peter Pie. That's my name.
No! Oh great, it's only in Neverland? What a waste.
Yeah, well, that's because it's a hot thing. Flying kind of sucks.
actually, flying rules in everything ever.
Mm-hmm. It's true, future friend.
So yeah, essentially flying is just like how swimming worked, except you're way less constrained.
Right. Yeah. So that time you just jumped off the pirate ship, it was totally intentional.
Yeah, no, Sora wanted to die, but he had some last minute stunts.
He's like, wait a minute, oh, I've never kissed Kairi, and then he's like, oh, I'm back.
Okay, so this area actually also has two other enemies. These little pirate gargoyles. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
They're like the Halloween Town gargoyles. They punch the shit out of you.
Right.
Yeah. And it also has a completely unique enemy that pretty sure will show up soon.
The crocodile. Oh,
there we go. The pirate what? Ship. So
what
the pirate ship, it can charge at you, and it can load up its cannonballs and just kind of throw this up in the air and shoot you that way.
I see.
It also has a rocket, I believe, but it doesn't use it that much. That homes in on you. One weird but neat thing about this pirate ship is that it's split up into four parts. Basically, hitting a certain part enough will destroy it and make one of its attacks unavailable.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah.
That is pretty cool.
I'm pretty sure that's only used once, but that's cool.
Yeah, it's a weirdly designed enemy that only pops up, like, here in the Colosseum.
Mm-hmm.
Kingdom Hearts 1, proof of concept.
Aye, Captain. They walk the plank, every last one of them.
Hit me again with that ass stack!
Now it's your turn to walk.
Ah, Peter Pan, you and your weird anal focus. So guys, ready to fight Hook?
Yeah.
Yes, let's beat the shit out of him.
Just ignore the thing shooting at you?
Yeah. Alright, yeah, you can just walk away from that battle.
Cool.
Oh, that's pretty neat.
So yeah, Hook has a thing where both he and Peter Pan just kind of go crazy with sound clips, but also he can summon, like, those airships every once in a while. So, in general, those will obviously be a problem you have to deal with. One thing about Hook is that, in general, he has some attacks that rush in on you, and you should aim for the water, because Hook will instantly get scared of that fucking crocodile and just fucking leg it back to his ship. Which is a good time to hurt him.
Yeah, that's an interesting mechanic.
Yeah. Wow, look at all these cool mechanics that'll never be relevant again. But I mean, like, it's nice that they used it for this world. This feels kind of like the Nightmare Before Christmas thing. They really enjoyed putting in all these, like, ideas, and then they never get to reuse them.
Hey, look how we're in a large open area with a skybox in the distance.
Also, Hook has two moves. He just showed up. He has his counter move, which is where his Hook gets off Chloe. If you attack him there, he just beats the shit out of you.
Okay.
He also has a berserk mode, where he just kind of chases after you, and if you get in his range, he just fucks your shit up.
I'm noticing a trend here.
Yeah, you can cancel that by getting him to go into the water, though.
Okay. I notice he's trying to throw, like, presents at you?
Yeah, that's what it looks like.
Those are bombs.
Hook
doesn't fuck around, buddy! He's a straight-up terrorist!
This is the worst Christmas ever.
I think I remember that from the movie, but I thought he was doing a Faust thing for a second from Guilty Gear. Just, like, throwing shit in the air and random shit explodes.
Yeah, gonna put his fingers in Goofy's butt?
No, please, that's what Peter Pan does. Remember that knife thing?
Oh yeah, of course.
Oh, it did explode. It is a bomb.
It is very surreal to see our dead friends floating above us. I have to say that.
Their last thoughts were happy.
Oh, holy shit, I'm flying, boy! And Peter Pan's last happy thoughts were...
I don't know if Peter Pan is canonically a bird.
He just likes to crow.
Okay. I can't blame him for that.
Yeah, this is real fair.
That's rude.
I think we consider this like a gang beatdown.
You can't write that off as self-defense anymore.
Like, that's straight up the American History X curb stomp scene brutality level.
Pirate flag, he doesn't claim defense under any laws.
And then he ran off into the skybox.
My god, did he walk in water? Did we find a messiah?
Hmm.
Oh, Kairi couldn't wake up, so maybe she's really lost her...
Maybe she's fucking dead.
I can't believe it. She really flew.
Wait, oh, no, he's got crazy.
Yeah, Kairi, I can't wait. We're gonna go back and we're gonna have fun games on the beach, make a sandcast. It's gonna be great.
I can't... Gisora, Donald... Goofy, do you want to go to heaven just like Kairi?
About flying, the pirates, and everything else that's happened.
And all that other stuff I don't remember.
What's that, Tink? What about the clock tower? You say there's something there.
Oh, this is jaunty music.
Welcome to the magical Disney World of London.
My favorite Disney World.
You get to meet as many exciting fantasy locales like the London Museum, the Big Ben,
the Tower Bridge,
and this old lady with a crown.
Nice.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Okay. Hey, don't attack Big Ben! What the heck?
We have to fix it. We have to fix the Big Ben by destroying it.
Well, you know, the Big Ben isn't really the clock tower.
Canonically, the Queen is the clock tower?
Yes.
I love that series. They couldn't, like, center that or anything? They just shove it on the three? Oh, it's not even on the this is awful.
Just the 2.5.
Well, it's 2.5 o'clock. I guess it's time to close the keyhole.
Then it opens the clock face, and it's just a painting of Henry the VII's dick.
Finally.
Nice.
You see, it was centered when all of this was built initially, but then after the Great Fire of London, everything was rebuilt. So the level was skew.
Oh, and some of the seismic shifts, I get it. Okay.
Man, you look like an alien baby, Riku.
That's the real secret. Riku's not human.
That's right. They say she's a meteor baby.
Wow. A star child. Yes.
Thank you, Director's Cut, for providing that vital context.
Were those lights supposed to be blinking? That was awful.
Alright, Riku likes, Kairi, Adore. Riku dislikes Sora.
That's what I've learned today.
Yeah, time to edit the wiki page.
Relying too heavily.
Clearly still wants to be friends with Sora, that's why he made that alternate Sora. He's just one of those friends that gets mad when his friends make other friends outside of his circle.
Though his world perished, his heart did not. When we took the princess from his castle, he apparently followed her here through sheer force of will. But fear not. No harm.
We're gonna have bodyguard detail put out. Are you 24/7, Riku?
Putting you into witness protection.
You're gonna have to grow a mustache, buddy.
Your new name is gonna be Johnny Keyblade, Riku.
They'll never suspect a thing.
He's named Johnny Keyblade on account of his one Keyblade.
I I love my new fart gas.
Really going back to Neverland?
With the power of flatulence, no one can stop me.
Sora will never smell me coming.
Wow, what's that nasty smell? It can't be Riku. Riku bathes.
You can come back to Neverland anytime. I just hope that, just as long as nothing bad happens to London in the next 50 years or so.
Oh boy, she's getting steamed again. Do me a favor. Look after her for me.
Oh, we finally get the good summon.
Hey, what? We just take her, take your fairy, that's it?
It's like a trade.
Well, looks like she's being bitchy again. You go take her. I don't like her anymore.
Ah, cool. We got a harp, too.
Yeah, apparently we both got her as a person and all of her belongings. We just stole that shit.
Also, can you guys please get me down from this clock tower? I don't know how to get down from
here. Yeah, when you jumped off, I thought you were just gonna fall.
She just spends the next 3 days stuck on a clock tower starving to death.
But I'm just a little girl. I can't get down.
Peter Pan does this, like, with every child. When he gets sick of him, he just sticks him on the Big Ben and he just dies.
That's messed up. Big Ben has a big secret.
Like most fairy tale characters, there's a lot Disney removed from the tale.
Ha 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 ha.